Greetings to us all over the world. What a marvelous time, what a marvelous hour. This is Yamkela Joseph. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord make his face shine upon your life. I believe that God is about to do greater things. The Bible says, for no eye have seen, no ear have heard, neither had come to the mind of men that the Lord has prepared for them that love him. So if you love God in this season, just be prepared to see greater things. Be prepared to see greater anointing. Because the Bible says, for the latter glory shall be greater than the glory in the former house. Today I want to speak to you shortly about what I will title a life without frustration. I don't believe that a believer ought to be frustrated. I believe that frustration, it is a symbol of lack of faith. It is a symbol of doubt. Every time we find ourselves in frustration, in distress, it means that we have now shifted from giving God our responsibility, but we have now took it upon ourselves to be in charge. Now, but I want you to go with me right now in the book of Ephesians. I mean the book of Philippians number 4. Philippians number 4. Philippians number 4 and verse number 5. The Bible says, let your graciousness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Don't worry about anything, but in everything, through prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any moral excellence, if there is anything praiseworthy, dwell on these things. Do what you have learned and received and heard from me and seen in me, and God of peace will be with you. Now the Apostle Paul says, do not be worried about anything, but by prayer and petition, make your request be known unto the Lord, because he cares. Then he said, now brothers, I say to you, whatsoever that is excellent, whatsoever that is lovely, whatsoever that is praiseworthy and of good report, said in these things, think about them. Now, one of the things that you see, the Apostle Paul is beginning to address the thinking patterns. He's addressing what is supposed to be in the mind of a Christian, because frustration and distress, they are the product of what is installed inside of your mind. Many people who commit suicide, it is because over a period of time, they have thought about something that has been troubling them, meditated on it day and night, and kept on focusing on that thing. So their mind was full on that thing until they could not bear the torment anymore. Maybe it was a problem. That problem sticked in their minds. Then because it sticked in their mind, they think about it each and every day. And when they thought about that thing, it ended up affecting their lives. Now the Apostle Paul said, do not be worried about anything, but by prayer and supplication, make your request be known unto God. Meaning that as a child of God, you don't have to put worry. Even Jesus Christ, he said, none of you by worrying can even add even an inch of the hair in your hands, in your head. He said, if the birds of the sky, they do not think about tomorrow, but the Father in heaven provides for them. And even, he said, the grass is clothed with splendor. Then he said, how much more will the Father in heaven not take care of you, you of little faith? So Jesus even himself addressed the issue of stress as a Christian. The many people are stressing as a Christian because they don't want to believe God for the next miracle. They don't want to believe God that he can take care of their lives. They want to believe God that he is in control. So what they do, they take it upon themselves that the responsibility of becoming great, of succeeding, of winning depends on them. Yet the Bible says that the race is not to the swift, neither the battle to the strong, but time and chance happen unto them all. So when you understand that your life is not in your hand, but your life is in Christ, you will cast all of your burdens unto the Lord because you know that he cares for you. Then when you understand that God cares and you put your total trust in the Lord, then you will be able to be as the Apostle Paul says, as the way that you have seen unto me, whatsoever things that are lovely, whatsoever things that are praiseworthy, whatsoever things that are of good report. He said, if these things are of excellent, he said, think about these things. So today I want to encourage you. Think about good things. Think about the blessing of the Lord. Think about what God has done for your life. Think about the miracles that he has performed. Think about how God has been faithful to you. When you begin to think about the goodness of God in your life, every doubt you had about God's presence in your life will fly away. When you count your blessings, like food, shelter, and every other things, you'll begin to see that God has been faithful to you. God has been trustworthy to you. So appreciate what God has been doing in your life and trust him for the next move, because he is the God that is in control. Do not be frustrated, because frustration, it is the enemy's tool to capture your mind. It is the enemy's tool to distract you from the faith of God, because it is a sign that you don't trust God enough that he is taking care. You are thinking that God needs to be helped, or God may be mistaken. But God is not mistaken. Each and everything that you are going through right now, God has calculated each and every steps of your journey. And he knows what is going to happen and when it's going to happen. And he understands that you are not going to fail. You are not going to become a failure in life. You are going to succeed. But as long as you trust in the Lord. So today I want to make it clear to you. Trust in the Lord and believe God for your miracle. And as you believe God for your miracle, I believe that something bigger is about to happen in your life. So right now, I don't know what you have been going through, but I want to pray with you, because I understand that if God said yes, no man can say no. If God is on your side, no man can be against you. So I want you to stretch your hands right now towards me as I pray for you, because I believe that God is about to do something bigger and something greater in your life. So stretch your hands towards me as I pray, and it's about to happen very quickly, very instantly. God will change your story. Father, in the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare right now, as they are connecting with me right now, whatsoever that has been in their minds, whatsoever spirit that has been upon them, tormenting them, right now in the blood of Jesus, I declare that demon is destroyed, that spirit of frustration is destroyed. Lord, let there be peace of heart. Let there be peace in the name of Jesus. You calm the waters of their lives and you declare that they will rest, my Father, in the midst of the storm. Lord, I decree and I declare that right now you will give them the courage to trust you in times of tribulations and times of testing. Lord, I thank you. I give you all the glory. I give you all the glory. I love you with every fiber of my being. Thank you, Heavenly Father. My friend, I believe that God is already touching your life. I believe that God is already doing something bigger in your life. And as long as you trust God, as long as you are faithful to him, as long as you trust him for greater things in your life, he will surely do it. For he's not a man that lies, neither a son of man that repents. Whatsoever that he has spoken, surely he will do it. So I want you to trust in the Lord, because those that trust in him, they are like Mount Zion. They can never be shaken. So right now, I want to say I love you so much. This is Jesus Reigns. Continue to watch our channel. Make sure that you subscribe. Make sure that you share the videos with a lot of people, because I believe that God wants to reach the whole world. Jesus ought to reign all over the world. My name is Yamkela. Until I see you next time. Shalom. I love you.